You guys can argue with me. I think I probably am the most lucky person and have one of the coolest neighbors. Every morning, obviously, I leave the house with a different car. That's besides the point. Every single time, he's like out in front of his house and he's going like this because he wants to hear it.
So, you know, I gotta make some noise for him.
So my friend Andy is coming in today, who's gonna be my crew chief this year for my Pro 2 program. He's basically flying in to check out the car so we can go over and have a meeting and like talk about a lot of stuff since he isn't super familiar with the car, even though he did technically work for Mesker and Werthaus that have very, very, very similar cars. Mesker's an S13 with a 3.4 JZ, Werthaus guy's JZ S15. So not that they're like super similar because there could be a lot of differences and stuff. But anyway, we just thought it'd be a good idea rather than waiting till the first round to have him come in, take a look at everything and just hang out. So in an ideal world, Sunday is going to be our last testing session with the S15. Now we've got the proper tires on the car, the Achilles 255s in the rear, and then in the front, also the same 255s, but a 3517. So we can finally set up the car and drive it exactly how it will be for FD. The first thing, Alberto, what was it, yesterday or whatever, you changed to the spare turbo we had?
Yeah, 1 to 2 days ago.
So we did kind of inspect the old turbo. It is possible maybe it was smoking a little bit, but in terms of shaft play, we've been running this thing basically maxed out with no wastegate, and it's still solid. So we're gonna send it back and Garrett's gonna inspect it and make sure everything's okay so we can get another spare one. But for now, the internal section has been replaced, so we're all set on that. So there wasn't an issue with the clutch. However, that car's cold. I don't like when people cold rev my car. It makes me feel like someone's shooting a needle in my chest. So they wanted to make sure that that noise wasn't anything to worry about. So
I ended up taking the whole transmission apart, diagnosed it. It seems that once again we had one dog ring on the way to go bad. It's not completely bad, but this time it's third gear instead of fourth. Then we took the clutch all apart, inspected the disc and everything. We didn't see anything obviously wrong with it. Put it all back together. And also, we had a small oil leak on the engine by the oil filter housing. I took all the fittings out, put some new tread sealer on there, and so far so good. We changed that air filter now. We got that big one. I know you wanted that huge air filter, so you have like less flow restriction. I think that's as good as it gets.
So there's a lot of things that we're doing to just basically be very, very overly prepared. So in the event that something does break, we can fix it in a timely manner. And we will kind of show you guys everything once we have it all set up in the trailer and everything. But one of the things Alberto's been doing as well is remaking every single line on the car so we have spares ready to go. So kind of cool just trying to be preventative and have as many spare parts and stuff as we can to just quickly change things.
Yeah. It makes a lot less work. So if you have one line leaking, let's take the whole line off, put another one, and then fix the other one later. So it's good to go. Especially in front of my grip, you have a 5-minute rule. So if something goes bad, you only have 5 minutes to fix it. It could be something catastrophically bad or something as simple as replacing a hose. So if you have to make the hose from scratch, you're not gonna be able to do it in 5 minutes. Bro, replacing it, yes, you can definitely get away with it.
So I told you guys Andy has a lot of experience working on this stuff. And first thing you notice on the car.
So first thing we noticed when we showed up is the drive shaft, the U-joint, was actually banging around inside the, what do you call them, U-joint collars.
So these old ones, I guess, had a ton of play in them to where we thought it was normal. The drive shaft slid back and forth a bunch, but I guess not.
No, that's not normal. But those things, they do tend to wear out if you over-torque them or, you know, if you stress them. And sometimes they're just not the right ones. So. And then we noticed that coming up front with the big tires that he's going to be running, they going full lock, we're running into the sway bar blades. So Alberto over there bent out or pushed out about a quarter of an inch, so now we have all the clearance we need, and you know, everything works great.
Just simple little things, but trying to make sure the car's dialed before the last testing session. Just other minor stuff too, like Alberto noticed the exhaust hanger was cracked, or like one of the sway bar end links was in the wrong hole, but just trying to go over things. And Andy, well, pretty much everybody, not just Andy, wants me to raise the car because it keeps dragging, but
yeah, we're still gonna raise it.
We're not gonna raise it.
We're gonna raise it.
We're not gonna raise it.
You're not gonna like it. We're gonna raise it.
Just do it.
My logic is I'd rather be less competitive and be low and cool than
I'd rather be low and lose.
Shulman's telling me to raise my car. Shulman, you could go home. I'm just kidding.
I'm taking the most physical labor today at all because
I think you have actually.
He's right.
Okay. It's not. That's what the skid plate's for, right?
No, it's not.
No.
It's the exhaust. It was all dented, like, turning it out. So we gotta like keep it like that.
But it looks so cool.
That wasn't there.
This is like my new T-shirt design. Doesn't it look like one of those monster T-shirts that has all the scratches behind the logo?
Well, at least you did good because you hit it like in an angle, so you were drifting, not straight. So.
Oh, that is true, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, you could tell. It's my slip angle.
I got a half support. It's my job. I don't want to get fired.
The only thing that makes me somewhat willing to listen to actually raising the car is the concern that, I guess it's not.
On both sides.
Well, this, it just, it looks like there's a lot more space on this side for some reason.
But we've, camber arm is hitting on both sides.
Yeah, we have had an issue with the camber arm hitting this pinch weld. So I guess these arms are pretty weak. So yeah, that would suck to break an arm. I don't care about skidding on my diff, but
it's harder because you come off the bank like this, so that tire comes off a lot, so it gets the more squat.
Mm.
So you're putting the most pressure on that side.
And it's gonna squat more now that we fix the sway bar, huh? Yeah, you can see there's a little mark up there from where that arm has been hitting. Note to editor, don't add that clip.
Yes, do not add it.
Adam said something very stupid, so I can't put that in the video.
You're gonna have to put your pigeon body back. Remember from that meme, the pigeon body? It's like, yeah, the thing was back. I was like, oh, wait a minute, no.
Sometimes he says these things and I have no idea what he's talking
the
about.
The memes,
but
you
it's,
gotta
it's
remember
best
about
just
my
to smile
meme
and go
database
along with it.
In my head.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So if you guys remember us weighing the car the other week, that wasn't just for ha-has and giggles. You actually have to have the car under 2,900 pounds with you in it. Oh, over, sorry. Even, God, Sean's making me look like an idiot today, too. I know things, I just don't say them while on camera.
This is why.
What?
I'm trying to contribute. I bought Adam donuts so he can gain weight.
Yeah, it's...
Like, make sure we get the right gain of weight so he can, like... Plastic.
There's only a 50, like there's a 50 pound limit for ballast that you can add to
well,
the car.
You
but
gonna have all the donuts.
Well, yeah, that's what I was gonna say. No, it's unlimited. I can add as much weight as I want to myself. But the cool suit did add what, like 25 pounds was it? 32 pounds. So in theory, we should be good. Yeah, cause, well, it's full of water. But you have to be really careful and not just be like riding the line of weight, because if they weigh you afterwards and you're missing body panels or your tires are dead, like those things could be enough to set you over. I'm just reciting what Pat's been telling me this past week. If you guys remember too, those truck wheels, we did get mounted with the tires that came in, which are obnoxiously huge. I don't know if I filmed it in a video, but I literally like had a heart attack when I saw them because I've never seen tires so big. Look at how insane these look.
They're huge. They're so big I can only coat them one at a time. Usually I get like all wheel played out and I coat. I coat and I coat and I coat like one by one by one. But this, I literally had to move this whole wheel over there and then coat it, let it sit, and restart. So it's all coated now, so that's protected, and now it's way easier for me to clean.
Look at how insane these look.
Yeah, it looks really.
Dude, for like a size comparison, dude, here, like, yeah, roll it next to the S13 and hold it side by side, because it just looks so dumb.
Even moving it a foot is a tap.
Are they heavy?
Yeah, I can't pick it up.
What do you think they weigh?
I can barely pick it up, no joke.
I think
that's not exaggerated.
They're gonna look so cool.
I'm kind of strong, but like, come on.
Yeah, roll it next to the wheel so you can just see. Look at how ridiculous
example,
that is.
7 inches taller than the 240 SX door.
That's crazy. Dude. So we do have the leveling kit. I'm just waiting until next week since I'm gonna be trailering a bunch of stuff this weekend in case I need to realign the truck after I level it. I just wanna make sure everything's cool, so. These look so crazy though. Look at that lip. Dang, dude. Coating feels so good. Mm-hmm. Throwback?
That's what used to run on the 240.
Oh, yeah, you're right. But not this is a 9.5 though. It used to run 9s.
Oh, well, for me, yeah. Throwback,
so this is the most stretch you'll ever see on your boy's drift car. But we're doing Cletus and cars, and I want to be able to spin these things in second so I'm not sitting in first at redline and make my manifold glow and make my car overheat. So I'm trying to make some smoke. So I just figured I'd put some aired up 225s on. God, I thought you were dying. I thought you were dying, I'm not gonna lie. Oh my God. While Andy and Megan are in town, I gave them the Mustang news. They're ripping and having fun. It's so fun
letting people use the Mustang, getting to drive with it. Because I get to follow it and smell the ignites, just like
soothing.
Tweaker! Showman's first ride in the.
Yeah, that's my first ride. I'm excited. So far,
it's. You feel the G's, dude.
Dude, whatever you feel is amazing.
It feels like a sunflower, Showman.
Honestly.
Sup?
You missed it, dude.
Don't record this.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, the uploads have been a little all over the place. I'm actually really excited for today. I'm driving 2 hours back to where I just was to go to Cletus and Cars. How can I not go to Cletus' super rad demolition drag racing burnout pit extravaganza and get my Aussie on with my Z? So, I'm really excited. It's gonna be fun and chill, and I'm just happy. Like, there's it's not no pressure like a drift event. I'm just going, and I can blow up my car, and I'll win if I blow up my car. That's how you win, I think, in Australia at least.
Originally, I don't know if you guys, I can't remember if I said this in the video or not, or if it was in Cletus' video, or if it was in my video, talking about going out to Cletus and Cars, for whatever reason, I thought it was a good idea to street drive my 350Z there, which would have been terrible driving 2.5 hours with my Z and then risking blowing it up when I have a truck and trailer. I don't know why I didn't think about bringing the truck and trailer, but obviously that's what I'm doing. And it's gonna be a lot nicer because, you know, this is, I haven't driven the truck in a while. It's comfortable. I'm cruising. I got nice AC. I don't have WiseFab weird stuff going on. I'm enjoying the drive. It's a nice drive. I knew this event was big, but the amount of people here, it is unreal. I could show you a clip right now, but it's not gonna even do justice. I've literally been waiting in line and passed thousands of cars, all parked, all running. This is wild.
The lot where I parked is like very sandy, so the ramps for the truck didn't get it that high, and everyone just watched me destroy my exhaust and my trailer trying to unload my Z. I'm so embarrassed. Today is gonna be our last testing session before FD Orlando, so we're gonna actually like take things seriously and put on like my race suit, and if you notice, I've been starting to use like a Hans, but we're gonna really be taking some data since we now have the proper tires to be running the pump. Gonna have the cool suit on, all that jazz. Stoked.
It's not what it looks like. We're not cutting up a really expensive race suit.
Yeah, I bet it does.
Hey, shut up.
There you go.
No, we had to cut a hole for these.
Oh.
But you gotta also remember when you put your cell phone in your pocket to not put it in that side.
Look how funny and professional I look. And look at Tommy with his headset. It's like we're playing pretend serious people. So I'm gonna leave my G7X in the pits, and when we're making adjustments and stuff, I'm gonna have Alberto try to help like kind of document what we're doing with the car. And then Shulman's gonna be over at the spotter's tower with the dad cam with Tommy, who's gonna be spotting. And we'll have like radio systems and stuff. Look at us playing pretend.
Playing pretend.
Yeah. It's like we're all serious now. Drifting, we're gonna go skid racing. Also a reminder too now that we are running the car at spring pressure with the softer spring, which is closer to like 22 PSI, making around mid 700s for power. So the car's gonna have a lot less power, so hopefully we aren't just frying the tires off. The most difficult thing that we've been spending most of the time in our testing sessions has been actually trying to figure out how to dial in as much grip as we can, but making the tires last 2 laps. Because that's what we have to do, and they're only 255s that we're regulated to, and with how much grip the Achilles have, they tend to go away very fast if the car is quick and has a lot of power. So it's kind of riding that limit and trying to get as much as we can out of the car without just destroying the tires super fast. So if you notice, one thing that we have are these arm restraints, because they don't have windows, is to keep your arms in the car in the event that it rolls or there's some sort of collision. So if you guys noticed, on the bend we had that issue where the car was cutting off again. Alberto, you want to show them the log?
Okay, so right here, wait, let me focus on this. Wait, I need to zoom in a little bit. Alright, here I can show you guys the log. The pink one is oil pressure. It dropped all the way to 25 PSI when it was on deceleration at lower RPMs, and our oil pressure safety was set to 30 PSI, so if it goes to under 30 PSI, it will kill the car, and that's what happened to Adam in the bank. So I went ahead and lowered it to 20 PSI, so that way it does not do that. So we're gonna keep monitoring, make sure it doesn't go below this. It's still normal. Our high pressure is still at 101, and it's keeping good pressure on the throttle, but then as soon as you let go, all throttle RPMs go down. It went down to 25, little spike there, so we should be good. Ready to send it, man?
Yeah, I mean, as much as I don't want to drive it in the rain, it's probably good for us to have some experience in the rain, right?
Yes, very much so.
Having some issues now. I think my clutch discs might need to be replaced, or they might just be overheated or glazed, because on that apron, I don't know if it's going to be visible by the footage, it feels like my clutch is slipping, because I'll be in power and then it'll go and I won't have anything, and I'm very scared that that's going to happen on the bank. But we did do a good little rub, right, Alberto?
That was really good.
And remember, Andy told us to take off the bash bar.
Yes.
He didn't want me to touch the wall and then have it snap me back in, because he thinks my bash bars are a bit too rigid. So he took it off, and because of that, I didn't even feel that I was on the wall.
Yeah.
Can you film it?
Yes. Let's go see it, guys. Check this out. First, there's no wing. And then you look at the back, scrape on the very same exact spot. And this time, he went in deeper and actually hit the tail light on it. Then, taking this off. Oh, wait. It says like a little harder. Ah, there we go. You look over here, we don't have this side bash bar, so the rear is able to compress in and not bounce the car back off and send the whole car into the wall. So it just scrapes, absorbs the impact, pops back out, keep going, really good.
So we had one really, really good run on that last one. I don't know if you guys could tell. Well, obviously it was not the, well, yeah, it was probably the last one I included in the video. But what would you say, Andy, overall? Like, I'd say it was a pretty successful testing day. We found a couple issues with the car.
Yeah, I would say it's a very good weekend. And we found a few issues, but overall, you know, just getting him comfortable in the car and making sure that he can run as close to 100-point qualifying lap as possible.
I definitely think, like, I started playing with the way that I do the bank, and I found a much better way to be able to hit the clipping points. And although, like, I still wish I had more like tandem practice and everything, I'm feeling a lot more comfortable than I was before, and I feel like it was a really good way to just get kind of comfortable with the car, with the new front tires, with doing burnouts and everything. I just need to learn how to take these out more comfortable. We're working on it. Okay, you don't need to film my embarrassment. Best news of today is
that we didn't have to lower the car, even though we had to add the spacer with the Achilles in the front. I was really, really nervous. Oh, raise the car?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I was really nervous that we were gonna have to raise the car because it's sticking out more now. But even with all my hot boy angle, I still am not rubbing on it.
Still gonna raise.
Is it really not?
No, see, Andy says he's gonna raise the car, but he doesn't know that, like, he doesn't have that power because he lives far away.
So, look, Alberto's fired.
What?
What?
The Zeus fastener!
It's not tight.
Wait, can we start
What do you mean it's not tight?
Can we start calling Alberto Dr. Zeus?
No. Not funny.